In this video, I'm going to explain anatomy of biceps brachii. Biceps brachii. This is a muscle on arm. This is biceps brachii. Because name of muscle is biceps, that has two heads. Okay, I'm going to explain its origin, insertion, and function. Okay, this is closer view. These two places are origin. Let's check this part. This is supraglenoid tubercle. Supraglenoid tubercle. This is on scapula. You see that? This part is scapula. Supraglenoid tubercle. This is for long head. This is long head of biceps. How about this place? This is coracoid process. Coracoid process. This is for short head. So review. Origin of long head is supraglenoid tubercle, this part. Origin for short head is coracoid process. This is origin of biceps brachii. So let's check insertion. So this is closer view of elbow part. Do you remember? This is long head part. This is short head. These two parts emerge to this part. This is radial tuberosity. Radial tuberosity. Okay, this attaches on radius. Plus, biceps brachii kind of attaches to fascia on forearm. You don't see in this video. This fascia is bicipital aponeurosis. Bicipital aponeurosis. This is basically fascia on forearm. So, biceps brachii attaches on radius and fascia. This is insertion of biceps. So, let's check its function. Since this muscle closes elbow joint, this does elbow flexion. Flexion. This is very, very strong elbow flexor, right? This makes Popeye muscle, correct? Elbow flexion. Plus, this can make supination of elbow joint. Supination is when you turn your palm up. Palm up. Okay, this is supination. Flexion and supination. These movements are for elbow joint. However, biceps brachii can move shoulder joint. So let me explain function for shoulder. Again, I come back to shoulder part. Do you remember this part? This is supraglenoid tubercle. This is coracoid process. So you can say biceps brachii crosses shoulder joint as well. That means biceps brachii can move shoulder. What kind of movement can this muscle do? One movement is shoulder flexion. Shoulder flexion. I just said biceps brachii can do elbow flexion. Also, biceps can do shoulder flexion. This is very, very important. Plus, biceps can do abduction. Abduction. These functions are very important. According to Dr. Kapanji, he says if biceps brachii is torn, Dr. Kapanji says shoulder loses 20% of ability of abduction. But 20%, that's a big number, right? That's why biceps is very important for shoulder movement. This is freaking important. So, in this video, I explained basic anatomy and function of biceps brachii. This is very important muscle for elbow joint, but also important for shoulder movement. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.